Welcome to the Ancient Cookware channel, where on every episode, we show you different aspects of our products, such as how they are made, how to use, cure, and use our products, how to properly care for them, and even recipes which you can use to get the most out of our products. In this episode, we're going to take you to incredible India, where we will show you how the Indian clay pots we sell are made. To get to where they make our pottery, you have to leave the big city and head way south, until you get to the exotic land of Tamil Nadu. There, the pottery making process starts by the arduous task of mining the clay from the banks of the local river. The clay is extracted from the banks of the river in large, semi-dry clumps. The clay clumps are then transported to the artisan's workshop, where they are unloaded and left to age up to 1 year for it to achieve the optimal consistency. After aging, the clay is broken into smaller pieces and laid outside in the sun to dry. From there, they are taken inside the workshop for further processing. The smaller dry pieces are loaded onto large metal drums that spin and grind the pieces into a fine powder. Water is added to the fine powder and mixed further until a water and clay mixture is formed. The water clay slurry is then passed through fine mesh shelves to remove any rocks or impurities and left to sun dry in large settling tanks. After most of the water is evaporated, the now soft clay is further processed by passing the clay several times through large rollers which knead the clay until it reaches the correct uniform consistency. There are two different processes which are used to make our pots: hand thrown using a potter's wheel and using a jigger and jolly machine. First, we will see how the clay pots are made on the potter's wheel. The artisan starts out with a moist clump of clay, and slowly, as he lets his hands dance around the clay, he coaxes a shape out of the clay, making it rise and expand as if magic. The piece is continually shaped, and the mouth is eventually narrowed and flattened. Once finished, the artisan simply runs a piece of wire at the base of the pot, separating pot from the rest of the clay. The second method is using a jigger and jolly machine. To make a pot, a plaster cast mold made from an original piece is placed in the spinning spindle of the machine. A lump of clay is thrown into the mold as the mold spins at very high speed. Using centrifugal force, the soft clay is pressed onto the walls of the mold, and a tool on the machine shapes and trims the excess away from the mold. After drying for about 10 to 15 minutes, the clay shrinks and workers are able to pop the pieces from the molds. Before the molds can be used again, they need to be cleaned and dusted with clay dust. The pieces need further processing to make them smooth. Workers put them onto another wheel and with moistened hands and tools, they trim and smooth the outside of the soon-to-be pots. This method produces quality similar to hand-thrown, but produces more consistent sizes. The pieces are then taken to other artisans, which put the traditionally shaped curry pot handles on them. After drying, the pieces are known as greenware and eventually taken to an updraft kiln to be fired the first time. The updraft kiln works by having the flames move up through the wares and eventually escaping through the top. The loading is a tedious job, as the pieces are meticulously placed to ensure each piece is exposed to the heat. In the meantime, at the bottom of the kiln, a slow fire is started. The sticks on top of the kiln are then stacked with straw, which will act as insulators to keep the heat in the kiln. A slurry of water and regular mud is prepared. This slurry is put on top of the straw to further insulate the kiln and keep in the heat. The fire is raised by adding additional fuel, and they begin the process of the first firing. Firing a wood kiln to high temperatures is physically demanding, and requires constant attention. The firing lasts for about 3 to 4 hours, until it reaches approximately 850 degrees. The glowing red pieces are an indication that the kiln has reached the appropriate temperature. A second method used for firing is an oil-fueled kiln. The oil kiln reaches a higher temperature than wood kilns and is used for pieces requiring extra strength, such as cooking pots. The kiln's burners are lit and the flames are blown in with the help of blowers. When the kiln is completely cooled, the pieces are unloaded and eventually packed and are made ready for shipping. And so end the long days into meal nadu, and the end of the long process of making the clay pots.